Bishop, today, one of the great doctors of the church, St. John Damascene.
8th, 7th century, considered in a certain sense the last early Christian father, a doctor of the church proclaimed in 1890. Very powerful corpus of writings that have been a point of reference and a compass for anyone who would go back into the early church fathers and find all the evidences of apostolic succession and the grounding and foundation of our Catholic faith.
And a man who's, once again, these writings are still part of doctorates and master's degrees that people are getting these very days.
Exactly, Monsignor. And also, beautiful, we always go back to the Office of Readings so often in this series, because the Office of Readings, which have been almost, you know, the Holy Spirit has led the church to take these selections for the church to be nourished daily. And here's a selection from the Office of Readings from St. John Damascene. It is from the Statement of Faith by St. John Damascene. He writes, "Purify my mind and heart. Like a shining lamp, lead me along the straight path. When I open my mouth, tell me what I should do. By the fiery tongue of your Spirit, make my own tongue ready. Stay with me always and keep me in your sight." Beautiful passage. The practice of the presence of God, that sense of, you can sense that he knows God has given him gifts and that he has great responsibility. So that image of the fiery Spirit, the tongues of flame of the Spirit touching his tongue so that he can proclaim the gospel and the truths of the faith. It's very, very powerful. These Office of Readings are so enriching, Monsignor.
I love that, and I love watching them as they come up too, because that second reading in the Office of Readings tells the story of the saint's life, sometimes the martyrdom, which is a great movie sometimes.
Yes.
But those stories help inspire us and help us to live our lives.
And Monsignor, sometimes you can take, well, maybe sometimes there's some dimension of scripture from the Liturgy of Hours, or some part of what you were saying, the second reading, the Office of Readings, that you're reading it as you do the Liturgy of the Hours, but then you can use it, maybe say, I'm going to use that for my mental prayer.
Yeah.
You know, so
yeah.
I so often do that, and we're grateful for the Liturgy of the Hours and the riches and treasures of the Liturgy of the Hours. St. John Damascene, priest and doctor of the church,
pray for us.